Mac is a very powerful device, but it is only worth it when it is used to its full capacity, and one of those features is keyboard shortcuts. I can move my window from my Mac to my iPad using a keyboard shortcut, or I can press this function key and get the emojis prompt, or even remove the background from an image using a keyboard shortcut. Sounds interesting? Then let's dive in, shall we? Let's start with the ones that you need to use 100% in your daily life. This happens very frequently with me. When I close a tab by mistake, I have to go to history and open it again. But if you press Shift plus Command and T, you can open that closed tab instantly. I keep a lot of tabs open while working, so I can navigate through tabs simply by using Command, Shift and left or right brackets to cycle between the tabs forward or backwards. Likewise, pressing Shift plus Command and slash gets this tab view to help in navigation between these tabs. This perfectly works in Chrome and Finder as well. In macOS, like I have shown in this video, if you press Command plus Control and Spacebar together, it will get you the emojis window. But now, if I just press the FN key, I can get the same window. So to set this, head to Settings. Scroll down and click on keyboard. Now select emojis option here. You can press FN key once and get the emojis window. Spotlight is Mac's best feature, but when you press enter after you find something, it will open that file directly. Instead, I can press Command and R together and it will open that file in Finder. If you want a file or doc for easier access anywhere, you can drag the item to your dock and it will be there on the dock. But a better way is to hold Command plus Shift and Control and T together. It will put the file directly in dock. I have seen most people using mouse for selecting an option when a dialog box appears like this one. But we can simply navigate using Tab and press on Spacebar to select an option. If you want to realign a line towards left or right, press Shift plus Command and right or left bracket, and that will do the trick. Use Option plus left or right arrow to navigate between words anywhere on your Mac. Then hold on to Shift plus Option and left or right arrow to highlight a complete word before or after the cursor. Now hold on to Shift plus Command and left or right arrow to highlight a complete line before or after the cursor. And finally, select the entire page after the cursor when you press Command plus Shift and down arrow together. If you want to know which words have been misspelled, press Command and semicolon key together and change it very conveniently from here. When you type in notes and select a word and right click on it, you get a lot of options, but if you press Command plus Shift and C on your keyboard, you can now very easily change the color of that text in the Notes app, and this change will reflect on your iPhone as well. I do not need third-party apps to remove background from an image. Instead, I can simply open the image in preview and use Shift plus Command and K to remove the background from that image instantly. I don't even need to select that image. Just using this keyboard shortcut will remove the background from the image automatically. Recents folder is very useful in Finder. And so Command plus Shift and R will directly take you to that folder. If you want a same file in different folders, so instead of copying and pasting that file everywhere, simply select the folder or file and press Command plus Control and A together. This will make an alias of that file without actually copying the data. Check the difference in size here. Sometimes when you download a file and cannot find it in Finder or anywhere else, you can hit Command plus Shift and period for showing hidden files on your Mac. Usually, clicking on the sound icon in the menu bar lets you toggle sound output on a go. But if you click on the same icon but with Option key this time, it will let you change the sound input as well. If you have an iPad, you can shift a window to that iPad. But a keyboard shortcut can be set for this. In Settings, head to Keyboard and click on Keyboard Shortcuts, then Applications. let it be for all applications, but you can set it for a particular app as well. Now carefully check the prompt that you want to set a keyboard shortcut for. Even the uppercase and lowercase has to be same, and type in the menu title here. Now add a shortcut that is not very common and set it. I'll set Shift Command and M for this. Now in any app, if I want to shift the window to my iPad, I'll just use the command we have just set, Shift Command and M. As you can see, the window is now gone to my iPad. In Safari, when you have a lot of tabs open, but you only want to focus on one, use Command, Option and W to hide all the tabs other than the one you are currently on. If I need to note down something for reference, Shift plus Command and Y amazingly converts that text into a sticky note, which I can then park at my desktop for reference later. When you have a lot of apps open and you want to hide all the windows other than the one you are currently on, so pressing Command plus Option and H will hide all other windows other than the one you are currently on. In Safari, if you are reading something and you want to bypass the extra ads and all this, Shift plus Command and R will do the trick and get the reading mode for you. We still have a lot of dedicated keyboard shortcuts for certain apps in Mac. Comment in the section below about which app do you want me to show keyboard shortcuts about next. Thanks for watching. My name is Mufaddal. This is Apple Vibes. Take care, and I will see you in the next video.